In this video on Google Earth Pro, we explore how to change settings. These videos were made possible by America View, Virginia View, the Virginia Cooperative Extension, Colorado Mesa University, and Virginia Tech's College of Natural Resources and Environment. Funding for this project was provided by the United States Geological Survey under grant number G14AP00002. The contents of this video and the related written tutorial are solely the responsibility of the authors and do not represent the official views of the U.S. Geological Survey. Mention of trade names or commercial products does not constitute their endorsement by the United States government. This video accompanies Section 5 of Chapter 3 in a written tutorial titled Exploring Our Planet with Open Source Software. You can find the written tutorial at virginiaview.cnre.vt.edu/education or at americaview.org/exploringourplanet. Google Earth Pro loads with many default settings, which can be changed. In this brief video, we mainly address changing the coordinate and measuring systems. We will introduce other options available. If you have not already, open Google Earth Pro. Once it opens on the main toolbar, go to Tools and Options. You will see this dialog box. Again, we will not be discussing each of these options. For example, the first row of boxes, Texture Colors, Anisotropic Filtering, and Graphics Mode, before changing these, you should contact your IT department. The second row, in the first box, Show Latitude and Longitude. Here's where you can change the display of your latitude and longitude into three different formats. Degrees, minutes, seconds are the most commonly known latitude and longitude. But you can change these to decimal degrees. All you do is check the radial circle, and your latitude and longitude will now look like this. Full degrees, and the minutes and seconds have been converted to portions of a degree. Then we have Universal Transverse Mercator, UTM. UTM zone 40R, and the coordinates in meters east and north of the zone's origin. Now please note you have only changed the coordinate system, so the elevation and altitude are still showing in the default setting of feet and mile. Change the unit of measurement, which is the next box in that second row, and now everything is in metric, meters and kilometers. You can also change the coordinate system to the military grid reference system. This is a system designed by the U.S. Department of Defense and used by NATO. For more information on this system, please go to the URL that is displayed on your screen. You can also, within settings, change the font that is displayed on Google Earth to 3D font. We won't do that here. You can experiment with that later. You can also change other options in this specific window to help with faster rendering. Again, we will not discuss these specific settings. Those are for individual choices. But we will briefly introduce you to some of the other tabs available. Cache is related to memory. Check with your IT department before changing any of these settings. Touring and navigation tabs are specific to zooming in and out and flying around in Google Earth. We will not discuss these settings either, as they are an individual choice and particular to how savvy you are with using computers for navigating. The General tab contains settings that might be helpful with regards to changing the language, especially for a non-English speaking student. Showing tooltips are individual messages displayed when you hover your mouse over a specific tool. You will see these displayed in other videos that we have on using specific tools in Google Earth Pro. Showing tooltips is different than show startup tips, which is the startup dialog box that opens when you first load Google Earth. If you are new to Google Earth Pro, enabling show startup tips is highly recommended. Finally, the last set of boxes, usage statistics, email program, cookies, KML error handling, placemark balloons accessing local files, and personal data. Please check with your IT department before changing these, as your individual educational institution may have specific guidelines to follow for each of these settings. If you have questions with regards to this video or the accompanying written tutorial, please contact Dr. Tammy Parise at Colorado Mesa University or Dr. James Campbell at Virginia Tech. The email addresses are shown on the screen.